Hi there, Sardar Gegadlop here from InfoWorld at IDG. Today I'll be walking you through another of Python's convenience features, the Context Manager. A lot of times in Python you'll need to acquire and dispose of resources, such as opening or closing a file. Context Managers use a special syntax to show you, at a glance, where the resource is used and where it's disposed. One common example of a Context Manager in action is reading from or writing to a file. You can do this by using the open command to obtain a file handle, but you have to remember to close the file handle when you're done with it. This can be easy to forget about, especially if the file operation is just one thing among many that you're juggling. The open command, though, can also be used as a context manager itself, and that gives us a way to see how context manager syntax works in action. Instead of getting the file handle from open, as what a function would yield, we use the syntax with, as, and an indented block. The file handle is assigned with the as, and everything inside the block happens while the file handle is open. As soon as that block ends, the file handle is closed. This way you can see in your code exactly what the scope is for the file's usage. Context managers also give us other benefits. If something goes wrong inside the block and an exception gets raised, the context manager will automatically dispose of the resources acquired, and will continue propagating the exception back up the call chain. This way, anything you acquire is guaranteed to be released in some form. Creating a context manager isn't difficult either. They're just Python classes with a few special methods. To show how this works, I've created a primitive version of a file context manager. The init method for a context manager is much the same as it is in a regular class. It just sets up the object in any internal state that we need. The enter method is where things get interesting. This returns the object that we refer to with the as clause in the context manager syntax. And then finally, the exit method runs when we leave the context manager for whatever reason. In this case, we will use the body of the exit method to close off the file handle that we had open. Now, exit can take a few extra parameters that are used for error handling. If something in the context block throws an exception, we can take it as our first and second arguments, the type and value of the exception, and do something with the results. In this case, we're intercepting custom exception and handling it so it doesn't propagate. If we return true from exit, by the way, that's assigned to Python's context manager handler that an exception was raised but also handled. So as you can see, if we raise custom exception, it'll be flagged. But any other kind of exception that we raise will continue to be thrown. Another way that you could construct a context manager is by way of the context manager decorator. You can use this to wrap a function which uses Python's yield statement. Everything before the yield is initialization and entry into the manager block. The yield statement is what's returned into the as variable. It has to be exactly one thing returned, by the way. And everything after the yield is turned into the exit block. If you want to handle exceptions, all you have to do is wrap the yield in a try except block and handle exceptions as you normally would. You just need to also remember to add a finally block that runs after both except and else cases, so we can handle resource cleanup. If you like this video, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube, and for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.